r/AskReddit by iReddit. Subscribe for daily Reddit videos. Girls, what do guys do that they think is being manly, but in reality is the furthest thing from it? Being that angry guy. Adults need to have more control of their emotions than toddlers do. Not being able to do basic adult things like cooking and cleaning. A lot of guys seem to think domestic tasks are feminine and should be left to women. But not being able to take care of yourself makes you look incompetent. Not manly. Never admitting a mistake. Guys who have to be alpha in every situation. Dated a guy like that. Any sort of social interaction. He had to go around to each guy and had a system to stare them down into submission. Seriously. BBQ with friends. Walks up to the guy on grill and starts demeaning his cooking. Then attempts to be taller and just stares at him. Then walks over to me triumphantly. That guy knows his place in the hierarchy now. You're with the most alpha guy at this party. That relationship didn't last long. Any man who must say I'm king is no true king. Edit *** since multiple people are asking. We got together because a few of my friends recommended him. I think it was one of those situations where they didn't know what he was like because they weren't dating him and had known him since they were little kids. So probably had memories from way back that helped them overlook the doucheness. I didn't have any such fond memories to keep me going, so that crashed and burned real quick. And yes, I know it was still a terrible mistake, and I was an idiot. I took a break from dating after that. Now with a super great guy who never talks down to anyone. Though we are guilty of skipping BBQs to stay in and play video games most of the time. Go Borderlands. Edit 2*** for those asking how he achieved being taller. He'd stand up super straight and puff his chest out. He was a pretty thin guy. I just remember one of the fellow party goers being like, does he think he's a p-? Starting random fights. Or being overly macho, as if to start a fight. It doesn't make you a man, to prove you can beat anyone up. It makes you a childish douchebag who thinks he can solve all of his problems with his fists. Generally. Policing other men's manliness. Thinking of a time a guy tried that's a girly drink. Shame on a friend. Friend pointed out that as a man, he'd drink whatever he liked, and you'd could piss off. Idiot guy was laughed at so hard by our group he left the bar. Driving dangerously fast. Sorry dude. Near-death experiences don't really turn me on. Guys who treat their girl like shit in front of people, to show that they are the man in the relationship. It always makes me think that in private. They must be very insecure about their masculinity. I find gentle and affectionate men to be the manliest ones. Edit, thank you so much for my first ever gold. 3. My wife says, bumper sticker on your truck that says panty dropper. She apparently saw this the other day. Bragging about wealth. It's very lame when you hear a dude bragging about being upper middle class. Especially when they are just the typical broke college student pretending for attention. Dated a guy who bragged about never eating. He thought it *READING was nerdy. No, you're just being immature. Same guy also did crazy stupid stunts, which could seriously endanger his life, like climb to the 4th floor balcony on the outside of the apartment complex. Just because. Edit, why I dated the guy. Okay. I dated him because he was really charming and kind. And since he was such an adventurer slash stuntman slash nutjob, it was exciting for a while. I'm quite calm and passive myself. I got to do loads of exciting stuff and unexpected adventure. Then I got exhausted from running around all the time and had to sit down. That's when he ran away from me. I have an ex that would make me walk a few paces behind him because he was the man and was leading me. Also, if I would speak up about something in public, he would shoot me dagger eyes to quiet me. Fuck that guy. My most recent boyfriend would be loving behind closed doors. But in front of his friends would tease me and would joke around in a hurtful way. But he's just kidding, haha, because he's a man and bitches ain't shit, or whatever he was trying to demonstrate to his boys. I brought it up multiple times, but he continued to act disrespectfully toward me, and I eventually broke up with him. Like, wouldn't you treat your girl like she was somebody you were proud to be with? Even his friends seemed embarrassed for me. And don't get me wrong, I can take a joke. but at some point it's not joking anymore. Bro. You call those burgers? When I was snowboarding down the volcanoes of Hawaii with Chuck Norris, we cooked burger four times that size. Avoiding jelly food and drinks. If eating a crepe threatens your manliness, your masculinity is too fragile. Witnessed a dude trying to be alpha get put down, and it was cringeworthy. It was at a Super Bowl party and everyone put their beer in the cooler or fridge. This guy who is a friend of a friend is a douche canoe, and if he doesn't know you, he will try to intimidate you, and the only thing he has going for his intimidating persona is the fact he is tall. Well, he opened the fridge and saw some flavored beer in there and yelled out while holding up the flavored beer, "Whose pussy ass beer is this?" At that moment I cringed, because that pussy ass beer belonged to my friend's brother-in-law, who is a Navy SEAL. Well, the brother-in-law looks at the douche canoe and very calmly says, "That's mine. Is that a problem?" Douche canoe knows that the bill is a gunslinging, soul harvesting pipe hitter and immediately looks flustered and embarrassed while stating, "No, it was just in the way of the case," or some other lame excuse. The brother-in-law is very down to earth and didn't take it offensively at all, because he knows he doesn't need to prove himself. TL. Dr. Navy SEAL administers a dose of reality to a douche canoe. Acting like they have tons of money. I have actually had to sit and listen to guys talk about how flush they are on several occasions. They talk about how much their vehicles cost, how big their home is, and about their bonuses and paychecks. Sometimes I've just sat there and laughed on the inside, because I've actually made more money than some of these guys were bragging to me about. Money doesn't equal manliness or instant attraction for me. It just makes you sound like a douchebag. I'd much rather hear about what you do for a living, your passions, or your plans for the future. Guys with passion and a plan are very sexy. Thinking they have to be manly. Just be yourself. All that other shit is fake and dumb. People are people. Be one, not some artificial stereotype. The best guys I have ever known didn't play the manly game. Edit. Being naturally macho is different than acting and doing what you can. You seem manly. It just isn't fair to yourself to impose such standards, and it most often doesn't matter to people who you could form lasting relationships with. Thinking they are teaching the lady something when in reality, they are condescending and being ridiculously presumptuous. I play D&D with my group at the local nerd store, and every time I meet a new guy there, it's a 50 over 50 chance of him being either the chillest dude ever, or some self-righteous twat who needs to validate his masculinity by educating me on my own hobbies. I've noticed the chill dudes are typically mid-20s and up. The twats seem to be my age, early to mid-20s, and come across like a know-it-all 5-year-old trying to impress the kindergartners. Edit. I should clear something up here. They don't just do this to me because I'm a woman. I see them treat all of their male friends the exact same way in some dude bro pissing contest. I don't feel I've been mansplained, and quite frankly I find the term a sexist as the idea of it. Ladies, please give guys more credit. They are not always condescending specifically to women. Sometimes, like in my case, they are just general assholes. I'm sure the confusion is my fault because of my wording, and I both regret and apologize for that. Any guy who shits on mental health or going to therapy. My friend's husband once said, "Why is Bob depressed all the time? I think he's overreacting." Therapy. You don't need therapy. Come to me. I'll give you a shot of whiskey and kick you in the balls. You'll feel better. I sat there and shook my head. Edit. I'm not saying therapy is for everyone, and depression is a heavy word. But perceiving someone as weak because they are going through something just isn't cool. Edit again. I made my first edit because I was receiving some backlash that therapy doesn't help everyone. I personally do think it's beneficial. Not saying it's a cure-all, but a great outlet for those in need. Boasting about how much alcohol they can drink and how often, when they are clearly injured. Pretending that they're not hurt at all and refusing medical attention. Wearing really baggy pants that require you to hold on to your junk in public. Literally no woman finds this attractive. Not doing the emotional labor in a relationship. Any relationship, romantic, family, friends. It's not cool to be emotionally distant and not show people that you care about them. So many men think it's a woman's job to remember birthdays, give support when someone needs to vent, etc. Like, no. You want to have someone in your life. You care about them. Treat them like it. It won't make you less of a man to pat someone on the back when they're feeling down. Edit. 11 hours later, and I have my first ever gold. Thanks whoever did that. All these comments are interesting, and I wish I could respond to everyone. But I'm tired, and I have work tomorrow. I'm really happy to see a lot of guys step up and admit this is a problem for them that they're working on. I'm not surprised, but still disappointed to see a lot of guys not taking responsibility for how they can better maintain their relationships. Also, why are you guys so defensive about birthdays? My original comment was kind of rushed, so I was thinking of examples off the top of my head. Birthdays came to me because I've heard a lot of women complain about their boyfriends/husbands not remembering or doing enough on their birthday, while they had remembered and done something really thoughtful for them. If birthdays don't matter to you, fine. But if they matter to the people you care about it, step up. At the end of the day though, everyone has individual needs, and every relationship is different. Birthdays is just one thing, and they may or may not be applicable to someone you know. It's your responsibility to see how you can make a relationship better, and how you can put in the emotional labor to fix it. Google was a lot of results, if you want to look into it. Treating/talking about animals badly. It doesn't make you look hard. Not eating healthy. Real men eat meat and potatoes. Salads and light beer are for women. Everyone needs vitamins and fiber. And regularly having beer and chicken wings leads to a beer guy. Being intolerant. Especially homophobic. Just because a guy's gay doesn't mean he wants to have sex with you. Dude. Not protecting net neutrality. Edit, thank you for the gold. When they argue over something they don't know about, I don't understand how can they sound so confident, even if they have no clue. And it makes them look dumb and stubborn. Actively avoiding anything period related. Like refusing to buy tampons when they're at the store, or gagging when they hear girls talking about anything having to do with it. I mean seriously guy? Do you think you're gonna suddenly spout some over is by touching a box of pads? Being so angry. An ex. At family BBQs he'd have to put an angry face on. And like tense all his muscles the whole time. If someone spoke to him, he'd give a smart ass remark or ignore them. So glad I'm away from that. Revving their motorcycle engine at long stoplights. Not being clean. Not washing hands. Edit 1. Wow, I said this after work, went to bed, got up, and look at all the upvotes. Lem tell you a little story. I was married 23 years. Raised his 2 children, and had 3 of my own with him. I left him a year ago. The main reason? Dirtiness/lack of hygiene. It's only gotten worse with time. About 8 years ago the older kids would comment, every time dad hugs you, you pull away. Yeah. Because I knew how gross he was. This is a man who, never mind, doesn't wash his hands ever. Okay, that's one thing, but this is a man who I've seen clean the toilet by putting toilet paper on his fingers and reaching in and so-called scrubbing the fresh spots on the side. Also a man who, instead of dumping the bathroom rubbish into the main trash bag and taking it out, or having a liner, reached in with his hands into the trash and carried said trash to the main trash bag to throw out. Yes. Really? I could go on, there's other equally bad things, but you get the point. I'm in his city working right now, and staying with him unfortunately, and sometimes using his car. Yesterday he picked me up from work, and he was actually scraping the dirt off his steering wheel of an only 1-year-old car, and then leaving that dirt, and scraped stuff just all around him on his pants and everywhere. By the way, he drives Uber and Lyft. In the last year of our marriage I actually made a bed for myself in the walk-in closet, because his side of the bed was a dark imprint or he would lay. Unfortunately I stayed in the marriage way too long for the typical reason, the kids. Anyway, sorry I'm turning this into a rant, but I just had to comment on this, because when I saw the title of the post it reminded me of a time when I complained to him about washing hands, and he told me that real men don't do that and that's gay. Sad but true. Edit 2. Honestly. I really appreciate everybody's comments. When you've lived with this, and you've brought it up and somebody defends it, and offends it, and acts like you're the crazy one. I mean, I knew that it was an issue, but when somebody makes you out to be crazy, you do start to wonder if you are a little bit over the top with stuff. And like a lot of things in life. As I'm reading your comments, I'm realizing and accepting at a deeper level that yes, this was bad. I pushed that aside for a while. So I want to thank everybody. And to the person who doesn't think it's divorce worthy, I'm sorry, but it is. It absolutely is. It's sad. I care about him, but I can't put myself in that situation. Daily. Anymore. And this is the last time I will work in his city and stay with him never again. Everything I touch, I use a paper towel. I brought my own sheets. How I don't eat here. It's not that I'm not grateful. But I have to be. I'm not a girl, but I guess rational thinking can answer that question too. Things that I personally find unmanly as a dude. Frequently spitting on the ground. Using strong slang language. Talking about women as bitches, etc. Trying to provoke fights wherever they go. Walking around like they are the biggest thugs. Getting pissed drunk every weekend and thinking it's cool to tell everyone. BTW, in German, so don't be too hard on my grandma.